Hi guys, I'm Singh from India and this is the presentation of the project for Code in Place 2021. First of all, I would like to thank Mehran, Chris and all the teachers and students in Code in Place, which makes it a great and incredible learning experience for us all. So let's go ahead and see the code. This code I made to analyze a financial instruments data for the equities and which are being created right now. So for this code, I'm using most of all pandas library and scipy and matplotlib for plotting the results. So let's go ahead and run this code. What it will do is it will ask us the ticker name for the equities being traded. And okay, let's go ahead and write Tesla. And the result it gives us is the current resistance points. The last resistance point is on 6 June 4th date, and it is around $700. And the current support point, which is active right now. And this all data is being downloaded into the CSV files and the PNG file for plotting. So let's go ahead and see the plot. So what my code does is that it will generate the plot data for the most high values in the stock price and the most lower values, lower peaks, you can say peaks on that values, and it captures all the points, high points and low points. In similar way, it shows the all-time high data, which was around January this year, and project the resistance line from that, and the low point data near the all-time high data, and project the support point on that. Also, it is capturing the RSI values and projecting the data on this plot. And also, it is capturing the normal distribution of the daily points, daily percentage change points per day moves versus number of days from this recorded data, which I'm inputting into this code, and which is currently at 359 days. So it is showing that mostly the price moves around 0 to 0.5%, which is around the most, and it moves 25 days out of 359 days. So we can calculate the probability out of that, that around 50% of days out of 360 days, the price has moved only around -4 to 4% or like that in every equity. So I will be further updating this code to generate more data and analyze more data onto that, and to analyze more equities also. So this is my final project, and that was really great learning, and thank you for all the help we got.